Kemble Knight was a 38-year-old Puritan woman living in Boston with her mother and daughter in the year 1704. According to our textbook, The Bedford Anthology of American Literature, she was married to Richard Knight, but he was killed while on a business trip in London. Her husband was a wealthy man, and because of his death, she acquired his wealth as well. She was needed to take care of family business in New Haven, Connecticut, after the death of a family member. She began a 5-month trip from Boston to New Haven, Connecticut, to New York for personal business, and finally back home to Boston. She documented her trip by journaling at the end of her day's traveling. She was to travel with postmen and stay at inns when the postmen stopped for the night. According to Connecticut history, it was a part of the postman's duty to guide the travelers and make sure they reached their destination in good health. While on her journey, she wrote about and judged almost everyone she met. She thought everyone she encountered was way too loose with their religious views and practices. According to an article by Mary McAller Balkin, titled Sarah Kemble Knight and the Construction of the American Self. Also, in the book, it states that on one of the first nights, she stayed in a small town and she observed in her journal that the farmers are too indulgent to their slaves. She wrote, "And into the dish goes the black hoof as well as freely as the white hand." Knight was appalled that the families allowed their slaves to join them at supper. As a Puritan, she was strongly against rights for slaves and thought slavery was good. While on her trip, she and the postman barely ate, according to Connecticut history. The food at the inn was barely edible, and often they paid for the meal before they received it, and they saw that it was unedible, leaving them hungry and with less money. She did not like the poor living conditions she endured at the inn she stayed at, which might have led to her having her own inn when she settled in New London after her daughter married. Sarah was also a very independent woman of the time. In the biography of Sarah by Britannica Biographies, Sarah overtook the family business at age 23 when her father died, not her mother. Also, she took over the family responsibilities that her husband had when he died. She wanted adventure in her life and was thankful to embark on such a trip alone. As American Passages explains, it was very unusual for a woman to travel alone at that time. Sarah is praised for her humorous writing of the time. One of her first nights of travel, she comes to an inn very late in the night. Because of the way she was dressing, her social status, by her jewelry and the way her hair was, and the time of night, the innkeeper thought she was a prostitute. In her journal, she describes how she reacted. She was shocked and said that "I told her she treated me very rudely, and I did not think it my duty to answer her unmannerly questions." In the end of the night, Sarah Kemble Knight looks back and laughs on how the innkeeper tried to gain her trust back by showing off the fancy jewelry she owned. Sarah wrote in a way that many others did not back then. She added humor, wit, and charm to her writing, while others were strictly talking about their deep religious thinkings and sometimes boring and lengthy sermons. American Passages states that even though she may have had some prejudices, she manages to give a vivid description of early American society, describing both urban and backwoods life. The biography of Sarah Kemble Knight finishes perfectly by saying, "Her humorous travel diary is considered one of the most authentic chronicles of 18th century colonial life in America."